John Ross Waller volunteered to serve as a drummer boy in the Civil War when he was only 15. He was shot in the leg, but from his bed he dictated a short letter to his family. Dear sister, father, mother, and friends, this is Friday night, but I don't think I will live to see morning. But I am a soldier of Christ. I will meet you all in heaven. My leg has been taken off above the knee. I am dying at this time, so don't mourn after me, for I have bled and died for my country. I won't live till morning, so goodbye, my friends. May God be with you all. Waller died only a short time later. On September 11, 1918, Sergeant David Kerr sent a letter to his mother the day before the attack on Saint-Mihiel in France during World War I. He wanted his mother, his sister Elizabeth, and his fiancée Mary to keep their spirits up. Tomorrow, the American drive commences, and it gives me inexpressible joy and pride to know that I shall be present to do my share. Should I go under, I want you to know that I went without any terror of death. I feel wonderfully strong to do my share well, and you must try to drown your sorrow in the pride and satisfaction, the knowledge that I died well in so clean a cause as ours. Don't permit my death to bow your head. May God bless you and keep you, dear heart. David. The Americans broke through the German lines but suffered 7,000 casualties in the three-day offensive. 20-year-old David Kerr was among the dead. Serving in World War II, Tommy Kennedy had been captured by the Japanese at Corregidor and spent nearly 3 years fatally malnourished as a prisoner of war on what was called a hell ship. He scribbled this message to his parents on the backs of two family photographs. Mommy and Dad, I am not afraid to die. I just hate the thought of not seeing you again. Buy Turkey Ranch with my money, and just think of me often while you're there. Take care of my nieces and nephews. Don't let them ever want for anything, as I want even warmth and water now. Loving and waiting for you in the world beyond, your son, Lieutenant Tommy Kennedy. Kennedy's letter was smuggled from one POW to another, and it was finally mailed to his parents in late 1945, more than 4 years after their son had left for the Pacific. In early March 2002, before advancing into what would become one of the worst firefights of the Afghan campaign, 23-year-old Sergeant Josh Horopko wrote the following letter to his mother. Dear Mom, first I want to say I love you so much. You were always there for me. Second, you gave me the options to be a man, giving me slack in the rope to try to make the right decisions. We're leaving for Bagram to flush out 600 Taliban soldiers from the mountains. I don't want you to worry about me. Mom, I'm not afraid to die for something that is right. I just hope that I made you proud, and if I don't come home, I just want you to know I'll always be with you. I have to go now. All that I have said here are words from my heart, and I mean every last one of them. I love you and miss you. Your loving son, Josh. Sergeant Horopko perished in the ensuing battle. Emma Weaver found the following letters on U.S. Army First Lieutenant Todd W. Weaver's computer. They were written to her and their baby daughter, Kylie. Dear Emma, well, if you are reading this, I guess I did not make it home, and therefore I was not able to remind you again of how much I love you. I love you so much, will always love you, will always be with you in spirit. I know this time must be hard for you. Never forget that God knew what was best for us before we were even born. Take comfort in that. This happened for a reason. I could not ask for a more caring, beautiful, and loving wife. The memories that we have shared over the last few years have been the best of my life. If you feel sad, just think back to the memories that we shared. Look at our daughter and how beautiful she is. Be strong for her. Remind her about her daddy and tell her that I loved her more than anything else in the world. Tell her that daddy is in heaven now. I love you, Emma. Much better times are coming. I love you, your loving husband, Todd. Dear Kylie, my sweetie, although you may not remember me, I want you to know how very much your daddy loves you. Leaving you was the hardest thing I ever had to do. You are so very special to me, sweetie. You are truly a gift from God. The best day of my life was the day you were born. Every time I saw you smile, my heart would just melt. You were my sweetie. I am so sorry I will not be able to see you grow up, but remember, your daddy is in heaven now. When things aren't going your way, never forget that God knows what is best for you, and everything will work out in the end. You have such a bright and beautiful future ahead of you. And remember, your daddy will always be proud of you and will always love you. You are and will always be my sweetie. With very much love, your daddy. Lieutenant Weaver was killed by an IED in Afghanistan in September 2010. Sullivan Ballou wrote to his wife Sarah from Camp Clark, Washington on July 14, 1861. My very dear Sarah, The indications are very strong that we shall move in a few days, perhaps tomorrow. Lest I should not be able to write again, I feel impelled to write a few lines that may fall under your eye when I shall be no more. I have no misgivings about or lack of confidence in the cause in which I am engaged, and my courage does not halt or falter. I am willing, perfectly willing, to lay down all my joys in this life. Sarah, my love for you is deathless. It seems to bind me with mighty cables that nothing but omnipotence could break. And yet, my love of country comes over me like a strong wind and bears me unresistibly on with all these chains to the battlefield. The memories of the blissful moments I have spent with you come creeping over me, and I feel most gratified to God and to you that I have enjoyed them for so long. And hard it is for me to give them up and burn to ashes the hopes of future years when, God willing, we might still have lived and loved together and seen our sons grown up to honorable manhood around us. I have, I know, but few and small claims upon divine providence, but something whispers to me. Perhaps it is the wafted prayer of my little Edgar that I shall return to my loved ones unharmed. If I do not, my dear Sarah, never forget how much I loved you. And when my last breath escapes me on the battlefield, it will whisper your name. Forgive my many faults and the many pains I have caused you. How thoughtless and foolish I have oftentimes been. How gladly would I wash out with my tears every little spot upon your happiness. But oh, Sarah, if the dead can come back to this earth and flit unseen around those they loved, I shall always be near you, in the gladdest days and in the darkest nights, always, always. And if there be a soft breeze upon your cheek, it shall be my breath. As the cool air fans your throbbing temple, it shall be my spirit passing by. Sarah, do not mourn me dead. Think I am gone and wait for thee, or we shall meet again. Sullivan Ballou was killed a week later at the First Battle of Bull Run, July 21, 1861.